Dear students, now we will study 3.2 exercise. In this, we will talk about the pair of equations. The name of the chapter is Pair of Linear Equations in Two Variables. So, linear means two line equations. So, now we will study about their solutions. That without solving the two equations, how do we come to know which type of graph we can obtain? Whether the lines are intersecting, the lines are parallel or coincident lines, or there is only one solution with the equation, or the equation has no solution, or the equation has infinitely. So, what is the method to judge without solving that the two equations gives which type of solution and which type of graph? So let us talk about. There are three points, dear students, in this table. First, let me introduce the columns, pair of equations. Second column, we are going to take ratio. Third is algebraic representation or type of solution. Next is again type of solution. We call the solutions by two names, that's why I made two columns. Next is graphical representation. Graphical representation means which type of graph will you obtain when you solve two equations, but now without solving, the shortcut method. Very first, dear students, I have taken two general pair of equations, a1x plus b1y plus c1. Second is a2x plus b2y is equal to c2, where a1, a2 are the coefficients of x, b1, b2 coefficients of y, c1, c2 are the constant terms. So dear students, remember a, b and c will be the numbers, numeric values in case of question. Now, how do we come to know what type of solution is there? By taking the ratio of the coefficients. If we take the ratio of the coefficients of x and the ratio of the coefficients of y, a1 divided by a2 is and b1 divided by b2. If we do not get the equal ratio, then the type of solution is called as unique solution. And what does it mean? Unique solution means exactly one solution means they have only one solution. The other name of unique solution is also known as consistent solution. If the two ratios are not equal, we can also call them consistent solution the equations have. And if we make the graph of these two equations by finding out their coordinates, as I taught you in first exercise, if we make their graph, the lines should be intersecting lines. Means the graph you obtain will be in this form. Understood? If the two ratios are not equal, then unique solution, or we can call it as consistent solution, and lines obtained will be intersecting lines. Then dear students, in second case, again general equations are there. Now, if the first two ratios are equal, a1 divided by a2 means coefficients of x is equal to b1 divided by b2 means coefficients of y, and if these two ratios are equal, then we will take the ratio of the constants also. And if the constant's ratio is not equal to the ratio of A and B, then we will say the equations have no solution. Means we do not get the solution. And what is the name of other, what do we call by other name? Inconsistent solution. And when we plot the graph for such kind of equations in this condition, the lines will be the parallel lines like this, or in any of the slanting way the lines will be parallel. Then in third case, dear students, again general two pair of linear equations are there. We have taken the ratios once again, A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Ratio of the coefficients of x, ratio of the coefficients of y, and ratio of the constant terms. If all the three are equal, then we will say the equations have infinitely many solutions. So next is, we can call them consistent solution but dependent. The type of lines, the graphical representation will be coincident lines. Means the two lines will lie on the common points. तो दिखने में हमें वो दोनों लाइनें सिंगल ही अपीयर होंगी. को मीन्स कॉमन, पॉइंट्स पर इंसिडेंट होने वाली लाइन्स. तो अगर हम सिंगल लाइन्स को देखेंगे तो दे विल अपीयर एज द सिंगल लाइन, कोइंसिडेंट लाइन्स. सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू डियर स्टूडेंट्स. बाय टेकिंग द रेशियो इन फर्स्ट केस, फर्स्ट टू रेशियोज आर नॉट इक्वल, नो नीड टू टेक द थर्ड रेशियो. But if first two are equal, then we have to solve for the third ratio also. If that is not equal, then this kind of equations will be obtained in solution. And if all the three are equal, then infinitely many solutions. Now, dear students, let me tell you, whenever you will get this kind of condition and no solution, then no need to find out the coordinates of the लाइन्स इन केस ऑफ स्टेटमेंट क्वेश्चंस. अगर आपका रेशियो इस तरह से आता है तो इसका हम ग्राफ प्लॉट नहीं करते हैं. अगर पर्टिकुलरली क्वेश्चन में इफ इट इज गिवन टू यू दैट यू हैव टू प्लॉट, देन ओनली वी विल प्लॉट द ग्राफ. अदरवाइज इन स्टेटमेंट क्वेश्चंस इफ वी गेट नो सॉल्यूशन देन वी डू नॉट सॉल्व इट फर्दर. तो हम आगे सॉल्व नहीं करते. ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन कर देते हैं बट वी डू नॉट सॉल्व देम. इन नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइजेस आई टीच यू द मैथड्स ऑफ सॉल्विंग द इक्वेशन. एक ग्राफिकल मैथड हमने पढ़ा है जिससे इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन से हमें एज मिल गई थी फादर और डॉटर की इन फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज. ग्राफिकल मैथड है. इसके अलावा आई टीच यू थ्री मोर मैथड्स टू फाइंड आउट द सॉल्यूशन. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस दीज इक्वेशंस बाय टेकिंग वन वन एग्जाम्पल डियर स्टूडेंट्स. Let me take the first example in which the two ratios will be not equal. Now, one more thing, if in the MCQ questions, they will ask you, they will give you two pair of equations and they will ask you that how many solutions does it have? Kitne solutions iske ho sakte hain? Aur options mein aapko diya hoga ek solution, zero solution, infinitely, ya kuch bhi. तो आप बिना सोचे समझे नहीं बेटा देंगे आंसर. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट चेक द रेशियो, चेक देयर रेशियो, देन टेल व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सॉल्यूशन इज देयर, व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सॉल्यूशन एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ लाइंस विल बी देयर, ओके, इन द ग्राफ. सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू बाय यूजिंग द एग्जांपल्स. फर्स्ट एग्जांपल आई विल गिव यू इन विच द टू रेशियोज विल बी इक्वल. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई विल टेक 2x प्लस 3y इज इक्वल टू 7 और दूसरा ले लेते हैं 4x प्लस 5y इज इक्वल टू से 8 लाइक दिस. सो लेट अस टेक a1 बाय a2 2 बाय 4, b1 बाय b2 मींस कोफिशिएंट्स ऑफ दिस, अगर माइनस है तो माइनस के साथ लेंगे, 3 बाय माइनस 5. सो वी विल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल चेक द फर्स्ट टू रेशियोज. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सिंप्लीफाई देम, रिड्यूस देम इन द सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म, विल गेट 1/2. We can't reduce it in the simplest form. It is already in simplest form. Is 1/2 is equal to 3/-5? No, they are not equal. So in this case, we can say which type of solution is there? Exactly one solution or unique or consistent, and lines will be intersecting lines like this. No need to plot the graph. Without plotting the graph, we can judge. Now let us take the second example for when the first two ratios are equal. Let me take 2x plus 3y is equal to 7. 4x plus 6y is equal to say 8. So a1 by a2, 2 by 4, and b1 by b2, 3 by 6. Let us solve them. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Means first two ratios are equal. Now we have to check the third ratio also. Third is 7/8 already in simplest form, and that is not equal to 1/2. So which type of solution is there? No solution, inconsistent solutions, and the plot, if we plot the graph, we'll get parallel lines. Clear? Now dear students, let me take the third example. In third example, if the third ratio will be equal, for example, here is -7, -14, right? So let us take a1/a2 is 3/6, and -7/-14. Do not ignore the sign. यहाँ भी अगर minus है तो minus के साथ हमें लेना है, right? So let us reduce them. 1/2 ratio, minus से minus cancel, again 1/2, minus से minus cancel, again 1/2. All the three ratios are 1/2, so all the three means this condition is there. a1/a2 is equal to b1/b2 is equal to c1/c2, means infinitely many solutions, or we can call them consistent solution but dependent. And lines obtained will be coincident lines, mean both the lines will lie on the common points or wo single appear honge. So I hope dear students, the concept is absolutely clear to you. This we are going to use in second exercise.